All right, hi, I'm Bruce. I'm an engineer on the Google Play Games Services team. And today I'd like to share a little bit more on some new features that we've built to help you to automate your game publishing processes to the Google Play with our new APIs. So first, a little bit more about our team. So what's Google Play Games Services? It's a bunch of cloud services such as achievements, leaderboards, online multiplayer, cloud save, and quest. Shameless plug, I recommend checking it out if you have not. So yeah, let's say you're building a game and you wanted to push your game to alpha every day to your alpha testers, or maybe you wanted to localize your game to many languages, or maybe your designer just went crazy, right? And he has like tons of achievements he wants to add. So previously, you'd probably go to the Google Play Developer Console and pretty much add like this metadata like one by one. And we've heard your pleas. A lot of developers had a lot of tedious times doing that. So we've added two APIs to help you out. The first is the Google Play Game Services Publishing API, and the second is the Google Play Developer Publishing API edits. And these two can help you manage your game services and your Play Store data, respectively. So to begin using these APIs, the first thing you need to do is to go to the Developer Console and click on Settings, and then go to API Access. From there, you can follow the steps to set up the API. Once you do that, you should be able to get access to all these APIs. For example, this is an Achievements API that we have. You can get, update, delete, insert, and list them. And we also have an API to upload images for those achievements. So yeah, let's say you have an achievement already set up, and you want to get an API, so get the achievement. Here's an example. You make a HTTP request with the achievement ID, and you can get the JSON response for it. And pretty much the same thing for updating. It's the same URL, just that it's a put request, and you can just change the JSON data and update. So one tip is you should always get before you update, because that's how we deal with like the current concurrent updates. Yeah. So here's an example for the Google Play Developer APIs. You have to create an edit, what we call edit, which is basically like a change list, and you can commit the edit. So going back to the example earlier, let's say you want to push your alpha build every day. All you need to do is create an edit, upload your APK, set your APK to the alpha track, and then finally commit that edit. And you can do many other steps in between as well. So yeah, like here's a list of other things that you can do. You can change your screenshots, you can change your Play Store details, manage your testers, you know, add more localization, or do stage rollouts. Yep. So by now you might be wondering, what if like other developers can access your data, right? So no worries about that. We take permissions very seriously. You can manage it in the developer console as well. And only the owners of your games can access the data. So we have also two main ways to authenticate from the client. So the first is an OAuth client with this OAuth scope. One common mistake is to lift the scope up. So do include that. And the second is to use a service account. So a service account is basically another account that you can grant your rights to. And this is very useful because you can set up a build server and then use the service account to run your publishing processes. Not to forget, Google Play Games is also cross-platform. So when you update your achievement data, it goes out to all your platforms and you don't have to worry about it anymore. So yeah, with that, you should be able to automate your game publishing processes. And hopefully that will save you a lot of time, a lot of money. And you can finally use that time to maybe eat some cake. yeah, if you still have problems, check out our GitHub samples. We have Python and JavaScript. And also, we also have Java samples for the Google Play Developer API edits. Yeah, thank you very much.